Hello. I'm Mark. In this video I'll show you Corpus, an amazing software technology from TDT. As you may know, TDT manufactures powerful hardware and software systems for use in neuroscience research. As a researcher, you can program and configure TDT systems using a number of high-level Windows-based software tools, including our latest and greatest Synapse software. All of these amazing tools are designed to help you build experiments to run on your TDT system. This development path works great until you don't have a TDT system handy, or your computer cannot be connected to TDT hardware. The Corpus software, System 3 emulator, solves this problem. Corpus is a powerful software program that emulates our System 3 hardware devices. Best of all, Corpus emulates System 3 hardware to the lowest levels, and connects user programs through drivers, just like the real hardware. When you run Corpus, it will appear to your TDT programs that you have physical System 3 hardware connected through a standard gigabit interface. Using Corpus, you can develop and test your experiments anywhere and anytime. Corpus will even generate test signals at device inputs, and supports using your own test signals with files from MATLAB or other formats. Corpus is included in TDT drivers, versions 86 and later. After installing the drivers, you will see an additional Corpus icon on your desktop. I have no physical hardware connected to this computer, and can run ZBusMon to verify this. Now, I'll run the Corpus software, and you'll see a graphic representation of the emulated system here in the top right corner of my screen. If I run ZBusMon again, you'll see the phantom hardware is now detected and mirrors correctly the RZ2 device being emulated by Corpus. I can even run transfer test and verify all is okay with our phantom TDT system. Now let's see Corpus work with Synapse and see how the Corpus simulator is configured. With Corpus still running, load the Synapse program by simply double-clicking the desktop icon. Synapse connects to the Corpus emulator, just as it would with real hardware. Now, let's build a simple experiment to record LFPs using the PZ5 device. Clicking the preview button will switch Synapse into run mode. As you can see, the PZ5 device emulated by Corpus generates some very nice simulated neural signals. Notice that the Corpus emulator has now switched into run mode. This green LED indicates a circuit is running. The blue LED indicates Synapse is communicating with Corpus. There are also indicators showing the state of ZBus trigger A and ZBus trigger B. The two level indicators at the bottom show emulator processing load and amount of time slippage. You can see we are using about 25% of the available processing, and there is no time slippage indicated. If Corpus processing cannot keep up with emulation in real time, it will begin to increase time slippage automatically. I'll click idle to cycle back into design mode. When Corpus is used with Synapse, it will emulate the rig you specify within Synapse. Bring up the rig editor, and you can customize the hardware system you want Corpus to emulate. You can see that in our rig, we have a RZ2 with 8 DSPs and a PZ5 amplifier. For fun, let's add an RS4 to our rig and see it reflected in the Corpus emulator. By expanding the Corpus window to the left, you can see the hidden items being emulated. By default, Corpus hides all but the RZ devices to conserve display real estate. If you use Corpus without Synapse, Corpus will use a rig file located in the Corpus install directory. If you need some help setting up your rig, contact techsupport.tdt, they'll be glad to assist. Well, this concludes my introduction to our Corpus software. I hope you found it entertaining and informative. Feel free to give us a call anytime with questions about Corpus. Also, be sure to visit the TDT support page for information about using simulation files in Corpus. Thanks for watching, and goodbye for now.